first couple of weeks or something. It was just a block, and a palm. It came to the groin, and then a knee. But see, my arm was like this, and as you knee down, it comes around, see? And you're striking like this. So see how my arm is around his neck as I hit him here? Then, I just turn like that, and then slip in. Kind of wet out there, you know? Okay, so block palm in chest area, kick, knee, and then see. Look, if I just had my arm here and I need to look, it just goes right up to it, right? So he goes right up to here. I don't have to come in and grab him a knee. I just put my arm over him as I knee, then he comes up to it. And as I step down, see, I hit him here. Then, knee down, here we go. One, two, three, knee, boom. Same time at that time. We wasn't into this. See, blocking and hitting at the same time. We was just into blocking. Boom. Then as soon as we blocked, then we hit. See, then we kicked. Then we kneed. Then we struck. Then see the weights on this leg? Boom, so you're kicking. Sweep. So real slow. One, two, three, four, five, six. That's good. Check this punch as I kick to the outside of the leg. Don't strike at the edge of your hand. See? Then step here like this, and I'm gonna back slap him to the groin as I fall. My left hand protecting me. See? Okay. Maybe like a soccer kid to a shrimp.
See?
Instead of blocking out here, you're going to strike here. You're going to kick, you're going to shuffle, knee, and then push. You put the ball of your foot down, and now we'll just step in here and kick here. So one. When he's down here, I can't kick his leg. See, his head's in the way. But when I knee him, I let him go up just enough, right about there, and I kick. So one, two, knee, two. Now from here, it's easier for me to come in this way instead of coming around to here. So just go for that angle. Last time. One, two, shuffle knee, kick, home. Like this. Unconscious. Whoops. Is just here. You don't want to catch it like this. See? So you've got to catch it some way. So it might slide off of a punch, I mean off of just one arm, but if you try to catch it in this little V, see, it's easier. It's not a big one, it's a little one. See? Just like that. So the left over right. Strike. Right? this will be the hardest part for you. If I just stepped in and hooked here, like this, I'd be getting down, but the motion, I want to take him through and then come up around. So, here. Somebody, they stay there, boom, see, puts the weight on this other leg. Stepping out, and remember, you're not hitting up, you're hitting out. See? Out. Groin, face. Kick, salute, come down. Groin, ears. Groin, ears. Punch high, punch high. Double palm, back hand. Backhand, inverted fist, hammer, hammer, we jump, let the hair cool back, knee, knee portion, palm claw, punch, punch. See, so I punch with my right, now punch with my left. Bring it to your left shoulder, salute out, and end it. Hold it, hold it. Here's the new portion one more time. Here. Palm claw. Palm claw. Punch. Punch. See? Punch. And kick again. And so we. Opening the right, springing to the sides of his leg, solar plexus, side of the neck, salute, come down, temple, temple, solar plexus, side of his neck, block his kick, groin, temple, throat, throat, groin, temple, see, arms or legs that's coming at you, arms or legs that's coming at you, solar plexus, temple, solar plexus, temple. Now you guys were up to here, right? Okay. Groin, groin, bend to the body, bend to the body, slice from here, the chest area, downward, see, downward, solar plexus, side of the neck, salute, and come down. It's not just good to know that you're swinging the weapon to the front. You want to start going to a certain area, okay? So that would be your next step. The next stage in learning a form. Learn the movements, learn to strike, learn where you're striking. So in your mind, if you want to, shoulder flexes. I do that sometimes when I'm doing a form. I don't think about where I'm striking, I just think about, in what direction, but I let my body just take me there. But I'm thinking of the areas that I'm striking in. See? And then the next time I do a form, then I might say, strike to the right, strike to the left, strike to the back, strike to the front. But, but I try to change it in my mind, different areas that I'm going to do, different things that I'm doing, and then I try to put them together. I try to think of the area that I'm striking to the left and where I'm striking to at the same time. So that I start focusing then on the direction and the area in one focused motion. See? Instead of just going in that direction and then and just offhandedly say, oh yeah, I'm going to the eye, or I'm going to here, or I'm going to there. See, so you want the focus. See, so you won't get the focus unless you know where you're striking. You won't get the focus unless you know where you're going. Next. So. Okay, let's just do it. I've seen some beautiful studios. Nicest studio I ever saw was owned by one of our guys. It was Jim Lippis. It's not there anymore. But it was a huge place. The one room was as big as this whole thing here. And he had a enclosed office up front. But what really made it beautiful was he had an artist that was a student, and he put murals. Chinese fighting guys. It was in kind of a pale blue, and it was just beautiful. And the guys was in red and different color, black and different colors. And they painted a big dragon along by the side and everything. It was just gorgeous. Okay, John. Okay, John just forced me to drop to my knees. See, he shoot me. Might have my hands on top of my head, might have my hands here, or he just may have me down here, just like this. I want you to move. Okay, you guys want to try? Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
You have a little work ahead of you.